Hi, welcome back. Sorry for that. Welcome back to the 2016 IQA Quidditch World Cup final. Welcome back to the 2016 IQA Quidditch World Cup live stream coverage. We are here with the gold medal game, Team Australia versus Team US. And we are go. Australia getting the quaffle and pushing through, looking to get a first blood. And it is no goal, no goal called. And it is a keeper ball. US versus Australia, sorry, just confirming a few things with the stream, trying to make this as clear and crisp a picture as we can for you here with the gold medal game of the IQA Quidditch World Cup 2016. The US on offense, but beat before making the pass. The game off to a roaring start here in Frankfurt, Germany. We are live with the gold medal game of the Quidditch World Cup 2016. Team Australia versus Team USA. Both teams looking for that gold medal. The US looking to defend their title. Australia looking to win where they lost 2 years ago at the Global Games. Australia on the attack, passing it across to their, and the goal is good. Australia on the board first, the score 10-0, sprinting back to their hoops. And the US moving back on the offensive. Both teams with six players on the pitch at all times. Four of those players play with the quaffle, the blue and white ball that is thrown through a hoop for 10 points. The four quaffle players, three of them wear white headbands. They are the chasers, and one wears a green headband, which on Team Australia looks almost black, but is green. The green headband is the keeper. Keeper has a few extra powers. Australia with a long pass behind the hoops, successfully getting another goal. Australia pulling 20 points ahead of Team US. The US coach pulling off some very frustrated chasers and getting some fresh blood on the field. The keeper has a few extra powers that chasers don't have. Behind the keeper's line, which is the solid white line, 6 yards ahead of the hoops on both sides of the pitch, and the US has scored. The score now 20-10. US coach making a very good decision to make those substitutions, getting a hoop almost immediately after that decision. Australia setting up a play here, looking to maintain their lead in this gold medal game. A beautiful pass in front to number 62, who scores for Team Australia. The score now 30-10. Australia maintaining their 20-point lead here in this gold medal game of the Quidditch World Cup. The keeper behind their keeper's own line is immune to being hit with bludgers. A beautiful interception from Team Australia's chaser, and it is a keeper ball. If the keeper also has the quaffle behind that keeper line, they are immune from being attacked by the other team's chasers and keeper. A shot in on the hoops, deflected by number 6 for Team U.S. and number 13, the keeper bringing it up, and a pass across for a goal. The score now 30-20. It's a very fast-paced game here between Team Australia and Team U.S. vying for that gold medal in this 2016 IQA Quidditch World Cup. The U.S. defending world champions. A beautiful interception by the keeper and a hero run. And he has scored, tying the game at 30 points. The score 30 all here in this gold medal game. Australia versus the U.S. Australia looking for an opening on the offense. Keeper, their third superpower is that they are allowed to put a hand through a hoop to block a goal. Chasers cannot do that, but the keeper can. Other than that, chasers are just a very special type. Keepers are just a very special type of chaser. The other two players on each side wearing black headbands play with the other three balls in play, the bludgers. Some very successful beating by Team U.S., opening up some space. And it is a goal. The U.S. has taken the lead, 40-30 for the U.S. over Team Australia here in this this Quidditch World Cup gold medal game. Gold and global, not the same words, despite sharing many letters in common. Well, one of them's backwards. Moving on! Australia with bludger control, but have lost it on an errant beat. And the Australian receiver getting beat before they can get control of the quaffle on the attack. And the U.S. has scored again. A beautiful pass to receiver right in front of the hoops, bringing the score up to 50-30 in favor of the U.S. here in the global, here in the gold medal game at the IQA Quidditch World Cup 2016. The U.S. defending their world championship title that they achieved 2 years ago in Burnaby, Canada at the 2014 Global Games. Australia looking to get a gold medal here instead of the silver that they got in Burnaby. And they have scored, the score now 50-40. But the U.S. with a quick attack, too fast for our camera person. The score now 60-40. Both teams with such fast moves, such fast attacks. The play moving too fast for our camera to keep up, but we will aim to be faster. Number 3 for Australia, passing behind the hoops, taking the pass back, dodging the bludger, and it is a goal! The score is 60-50 for the U.S. The U.S. on the attack again, and that is a penalty. That was contact over the shoulder. A yellow card to number 17 for Team Australia. Very aware. Number 47. Number 47 for Team Australia. Very aware that they committed that penalty and taking a knee in the sub box. The score 60-50 for the U.S. A beautiful stop from Australia, both with the beater and keeper taking control of the quaffle. The yellow card will get the Australian chaser 1 minute in the penalty box. That minute may be cut short if Team USA scores during that minute. Power card penalties in Quidditch work very similar to penalties and power plays in hockey, except they are 1 minute long instead of two. The score 60-50 for Team US here in the gold medal game of the 2016 IQA Quidditch World Cup, live from Frankfurt, Germany. I am your host, Willow Rosenberg at Hacker Witch, and the US on the attack, and they have scored. The score now 70-50, Australia's chaser out of the penalty box. Australia back up to a full six players on the pitch. It is also possible to get blue cards on plays. A blue card is a technical foul and carries with it the same 1 minute maximum penalty time as a yellow card. The difference being blue cards are for less serious penalties. And that was a beautiful goal there from Team Australia, aiming for the pass but getting the hoop nonetheless. The score 70-60 for the US here in this gold medal game. Blue cards are less serious penalties than yellow cards. And the US has responded with another goal. The score 80-60 for the US over Australia here in this gold medal game. We are just over 10 minutes into this game. This game within 20 points so far in both directions. Team Australia doing a beautiful kick beat and a beautiful pass behind the hoops for a goal from Australia chaser. Number 11, I want to say, but it might be 17 when, 77, I was completely wrong. Australian chaser number 77 getting that goal, bringing the score up to 80-70 for the US over Australia in this gold medal game. A extremely close game here in the final. The local commenters are telling me that this is the most points that any team has ever put on the scoreboard against Team America in an official game. Australia with 70 points, the US with 80. This gold medal game here live from Frankfurt, Germany, the 2016 IQA Quidditch World Cup. Australia doing an exceptional job pushing forwards. They have passed back behind the hoops. One of their chasers has been beat and the other has been beat as well, and I bit my tongue. But that is irrelevant to the game as the US goes on offense again, pushing through, and a beautiful beat of number zero by number X on Australia, forcing a turnover from a errant pass, and it is a keeper ball to Australia. The US with bludger control, having control of two of the three bludgers on the pitch currently. Australia looking for the pass behind the hoops but can't quite get it, and it is a keeper ball. Australia, long pass, bludger back to their defensive zone. And it is another goal for Team America. Not to be confused with Team America, the really terrible puppet animation movie. Team USA up 90 minutes to 90 minutes. They're up 90 points 270 for Australia. Australia looking for the pass in front of the hoops, but missing, and it is a turnover, a breakaway. A beautiful, beautiful long beat from Australia. Beating out number zero just before they can score that hoop. And it is a turnover. Keeper ball to Team Australia. The score is still 90-70. For those of you just joining us, this is the gold medal game of the IQA Quidditch World Cup 2016 live from Frankfurt, Germany. I am your host, Willow Rosenberg, at HackerWitch on Twitter, and we are using the hashtag Quidditch World Cup. Some intense beater play happening in front of the U.S. hoops. The U.S. on the attack, and we have a penalty potentially on the play. One of the assistant refs speaking with the head ref about what happened. You can see there on the feed our beautiful assistant, Bob, who has been absolutely instrumental to the professional use or the professional running of this feed. Bob, my lovely assistant for both days here, has been bringing scores and water and telling people to stop smoking or standing in front of me as we bring you this live coverage of the gold medal game from the IQA Quidditch World Cup 2016 in Frankfurt, Germany. Team Australia. We will soon have a call from the ref on what has been decided. The score is still 90-70 for Team US, 20 points ahead of Australia in this gold medal game. U.S. beater sent back to hoops, and the ball is turned over. Don't entirely know why that happened, but it is a turnover. And the beater number seven, Burton, sent back to her hoops. Australia on the attack, pushing through that defense, but just misses the hoop, just hitting the top, knocking the hoop over instead of going through. And the U.S. back on offense. Deking around, an attempted tackle, and the U.S. has scored again, pulling ahead by 30 points. The score 100-70. U.S. over Australia, 30 points ahead. Looks like the snitch is gearing up to get on pitch. A 30-point deficit is just the right amount for Team Australia to be able to force overtime on a snitch catch. The snitch worth 30 points on a successful catch for whichever team manages to do that catch. Australia pushing forward, looking to get within that 30-point match. The head ref being beat by Team US, but refs cannot go back to their hoops as they do not have hoops to go back to. We do have a penalty potentially on the play from our assistant ref, Ben Pooley. Seekers have been called to the... Seekers have been called to the score booth across the pitch from us, meaning that we are 16 minutes into this game. The score 100-70. the snitch catch worth 30 points and ending the game. If Australia catches that game, that snitch, blah, we will start that sentence again. If Australia manages to catch the snitch before either team scores another hoop, Australia will put this game into overtime. And it looks like a yellow card to the beater on Team US, number 30, for sliding. Yellow card for sliding. The beater will spend 1 minute in the penalty box. Australia, with bludger control, having two beaters. And the Australian team has made use of that power play and taken them back in range of a win instead of overtime. The score now 100-80. The difference only 20 points. Going very soon into the snitch game, as the snitch will be released onto the pitch in a few moments. Excuse me, I am apparently getting the hiccups. We will attempt to nip that in the bud. US slow balling forward here. Australia putting some strong pressure and a beautiful block from number 62. And it is an Australian keeper ball, and they are on the attack. A push right through, brought down behind the hoops, but getting back up, maintaining the ball, and it is a goal! A goal for Team Australia. A one-man army in their keeper, number 3. There is a delayed penalty raised by the assistant refs. It looks like it is potentially a card. We're not sure. The score 100-90 here in the gold medal game. The goal is good. Team US chasers given a warning for a bit of contact over the neck, I believe. The goal is good, and Australia rushing back onto defense. The score 100-90 as the snitch is released here at the 17 minute mark. The snitch looking. Our snitch leading a chant of "I believe the snitch will win" here in the moments before the seekers are released. Of course, the snitch cannot possibly win unless we go into overtime, which it is not looking like we will. Both teams with enough points to win outright on a snitch catch. Australia looking to tie it up, misses! And we have a brooms down. A brooms down in the 10-second countdown for the Seekers to be released. Seekers will be on pitch almost immediately after brooms will come back up. Our snitch ref, Matt Bateman, captain of the London Unspeakables. And we have an injury substitution for number 19 on Team America. Number 19, chaser for Team USA, substituting off for an injury. The Seekers are released, and the US on a strong quaffle attack, and they have scored. The score now 110-90. The US looking for a quick snitch grab here, but can't get it, and they are beat. And Australia going in for it. Australia looking for a grab, but they are beat as well. Australian beater beating out the U.S. beater and going on the defensive of the snitch. And there's no goal. Australia almost scoring. Australia one-on-one with the snitch right now. Lost their headband and have been beat. And now the U.S. one-on-one, and they have caught. There is a snitch catch. The score, 100 to 110. Australia scoring just as that snitch is caught. The snitch ref, head ref, and ARs discussing whether or not the snitch catch is good. There are a number of reasons why a snitch catch can be deemed no good. If the snitch was not on their feet when the catch happened, the catch is no good. If the seeker used both hands, the catch is no good. Or if the seeker charged the snitch, the catch is no good. And it looks like the catch is no good. The catch no good. Australia still in the game. The score 100 to 110. Team USA 10 points ahead of Team Australia here in the gold medal game. Team US coach getting very angry and being pushed back by the head ref. The catch deemed no good, and the snitch sent back to, the snitch doesn't have hoops. The seeker is sent back to hoops. The seeker given a penalty, a back to hoops penalty for charging the snitch, and the catch is no good. The spectators chanting for the snitch. Again, I believe the snitch will win. However, the snitch cannot win. The snitch must be caught for the game to end. Unfortunately, Team Snitch is always a losing team. And the U.S. has scored. The score now, not 451, 120 to 100. 451 have nothing to do with this game. The snitch has fallen off of the snitch runner's shorts. Australian seeker sneaking up behind. Australia also managing to score on the quaffle game. Australian seeker looking for the sneak, but he is seen, unfortunately, by the snitch and is sent back to hoops. The score 120 to 110. The U.S. maintaining their 10-point lead, but only barely. The U.S. have scored. The score now 130 to 110. For Team U.S. We have a brooms down. Team Australia's bench yelling for the refs. Not sure what happened. The score, 130 to 110. This game impossibly close. So far, this game has never been outside of snitch range for either team. Australia spending a moment in overtime range only, but it is only a 20-point difference. Seeker for Team Australia not quite getting it, and the snitch falling off of the snitch runner shorts, and Australia has scored again, bringing us back to a 10-point difference. The score 130 to 120. Both teams looking to catch that snitch and end the game, winning the gold medal for their team. The U.S. with an attempt. Both U.S. beaters on the snitch game right now. A beautiful steal of both bludgers by the Australian beater, number four, stealing two bludgers from as many beaters on Team US and giving their seeker some one-on-one time with the snitch. All four beaters on the snitch game right now, and it is one-on-one with Australian seeker number 47 against the snitch. And it is a catch! There is a catch! The beating team, number 14 for Team US, making sure that assistant referee Ben Pooley knows something leading into this team ref meeting. The score currently 130 to 120. Team US 10 points ahead of Team Australia. If this catch is good, Australia will win the gold medal, defeating Team US for the first time in the history of international Quidditch. A very long decision and a very hard decision for team ref to make. Team ref making sure that they make the right call here. There was a bludger near that Australian seeker as they caught. The question I think now is whether or not they were beat before or after catching the snitch. This is an important and very difficult decision here for our head ref, snitch ref, assistant refs, and snitch. And it looks like they may have come to a decision. They have come to a decision. And they've come to a decision. The Team US coach is not happy with the decision. Coach for Team US not happy. And Australia has won! Australia has won the gold medal! 150 star to 130. Australia winning the gold medal here at the 2016 IQA Quidditch World Cup, live from Frankfurt, Germany. Australia beating Team US for the first time in Quidditch history, winning the gold medal over the US on a beautiful snitch catch from Team Australia. All of the supporters mobbing around that seeker who has been raised above the crowd, holding the snitch up high. A beautiful, beautiful win and for Team Australia. And yes, I know some of you at home are taking the every time I say beautiful as a drinking game, but guess what? It is time to celebrate. It is time to drink everything if you are someone who likes to drink and are someone who does not have to drive or is not currently driving. Though, if you are currently driving, you really should not be watching live Quidditch at the same time. The final score, 150 star to Australia over Team USA. Australia winning the gold medal here at the Quidditch World Cup in Frankfurt, Germany. Australia has won the gold medal. We will continue to stream for a moment as we find out whether or not the closing ceremonies will be happening on pitch. The closing ceremonies might happen at the social and after party celebration tonight. We are not 100% sure, but we will keep you trained on this very well-deserved Australian celebration. All of Europe, all of the world cheering Team Australia as the first country to beat the US in an international Quidditch tournament to take home the gold here in Frankfurt at the 2016 IQA Quidditch World Cup. I have been your host for the day and for the weekend, Willow Rosenberg. I am at HackerWitch on Twitter, where after this weekend there will be decidedly less Quidditch and decidedly more feminism. So join me on Twitter shortly. We are using the hashtag Quidditch World Cup for the end of this tournament as we wind down and celebrate this Australian victory, Australian gold medal in the Quidditch World Cup of 2016. I will turn myself off and let you listen to the crowd celebrate. Thank you and good night.
If you're in pain,
just give me 1 second to announce it. Hi guys, welcome back. I am back here with some commentary. We are going to turn the camera off for a moment so we can reposition to see the closing ceremonies across the pitch. The camera feed will be going dark, but we are still live and we'll be quickly moving the camera across the pitch to get you a live stream of the closing ceremonies and medal ceremony here across the pitch from me at the 2016 IQA Quidditch World Cup final or championship here in Frankfurt, Germany, live in Frankfurt. I'm going to send out a tweet to all of you listening on Twitter. Okay. We will attempt to get some sound once we have the camera set up across the pitch. We will get you some audio of what is being said at the closing ceremonies. In the meantime, to go over, Australia has won the gold medal, defeating Team USA in a amazing snitch catch. We have had confirmation that the beat that the U.S. contended had happened before the catch, the beater who threw that bludger had been beat before throwing it, and therefore it was not a good beat, and the catch was good. The refs did make the right call there, and Australia beat Team USA for the gold medal, 150 star to 130. I'm your host, Willow Rosenberg, at HackerWitch on Twitter. We're using the hashtag Quidditch World Cup. Our lovely camera person, Hannah Fredericks, and our beautiful assistant, Bob, are getting our camera set up across the pitch to get you a live feed of the closing ceremony is happening right now. Right now, we are having some discussion from tournament director Matthew Gunzel, thanking the IQA for putting this together. And it looks like we are almost have the camera connected again. We'll hopefully have you a feed very shortly. So far, we have tournament director Matthew Gunzel giving out thank yous to everyone who has helped out with this tournament. The IQA Peterson Brooms for supplying brooms and snitch shorts to this game, and hoops for that matter. We are hopefully going to be back up soon. Sorry. That is my first time swearing on the live feed. I apologize profusely. We have not been able to find a power connection across the field, and so Bob has sprinted back over to get the camera battery and is sprinting back. Bob, a true champion. This live stream would not have happened without Bob's amazing assistance, bringing us scores, bringing us food and water, and running back and forth telling people to get out of the way and making the feed continue for you, our dear viewers. I'm going to pull down these flags shortly. And we have feedback.
Literally, he didn't even sign up to run this tournament and accidentally did. I hate it when that happens. Also, Yana Mears. Yana, where you at? Again, she's been helping keep you guys patched up. Really appreciate that. Also, Lottie Ashley. She's around somewhere. Lottie has a great story because she's not on committee and not involved in Quidditch in any sort of way, but her older sister is on committee and dragged her along. Being an older sibling, I know that feeling all too well. Next up, Erin Mallory, who head ref to finals. Really appreciate her working at referee workshops and all that kind of stuff over the 4 days. She's been great. Also, Chris Lecomte, for exactly the same reason, running all the referee workshops and just being a great source of advice for us. Next up, the snitch for our final, Wesley Mackey. Wes, where you at? Yeah, where? I'm pretty sure Wes has snitched more games this weekend than I've organised. And I'm pretty sure I organised most of them. Yeah, also, the volunteers get here every day around 6:30. We got here and Wesley was already carrying 10 chairs. I didn't even know the facility was open that early. But hey, apparently it is. We also want to thank some people, specifically the facility. So Stefan, who's like the head's groundkeeper, for dealing with my kind of nonsense about saying all sorts of random things and asking to steal the buggy. If you've seen me on the buggy, you know how much that means to me. And I'm sorry, Stefan, for all the garbage bins I hit as I was learning how to drive. I also want to thank Thomas, who's been heading the catering, who about an hour ago, when I went to him and said, hey, could you sell the beer cheaper? He was like, yeah, yeah. Ah, that's good. So big up, Thomas. I also want to thank Nicole Hammer, wherever she is. Nicole, give a wave. Come over here. Nicole had no reason whatsoever to come to this tournament, but apparently got here and has basically done everything. So really thank you. She's basically part of the organising team. I really appreciate her being here. So a good big round of applause. All right, I'm nearly done, I promise. I'm getting through it. Next up, I need to talk about the organising team a little bit. I might ramble a little bit, but that's because they're amazing humans and you deserve to know their life stories. Their biographies will be available on the IQA website shortly after this event. They may not be, but I'm going to try my best. All right, so let's get started. Tom Challoner? Yeah! So, those of you from the UK will know that Tom has ran loads of tournaments. When he signed up to this tournament, I don't think he realised that he was going to be official tournament dog's body with such glorious tasks as holding the microphone during the opening ceremony. And helping me empty the garbage. Nonetheless, it's really these kind of people who make the events happen, and I really appreciate it, Tom, so thank you very much. Okay, next up, I think most of you guys know this person, Bex Alley. Bex. I've had so many people today come up to me like, Matt, you really pulled off like a great event. And I was like, I've known anything. Like, Bex has literally ran most of the things. 90% of the time, and someone asked me something, I'm like, have you asked Bex? Like, I'm not really sure.
That's why so many people are asking me stuff.
Oh, sorry. Bex is the one that knows how to make a big noise. All right, next up, Pauline. Pauline, where you at? So a little story about Pauline. If you hadn't noticed, the World Cup organising team are a bit of an odd bunch of people. Pauline joined a few months late and we had already kind of made great friendships and lots of in-jokes. Pauline just rolled with it, was amazing. And then this weekend has literally worked the hardest out of anyone else, making sure referees and snitches are at their game exactly on time. Give her a big round of applause, really appreciate that. Okay, next up, BB Ashley, BB. So BB's been responsible for doing the volunteers this weekend. Most of us on committee have done some sort of tournament work before. BB hasn't. So what in BB's mind made her think, you know what would be a really great way for me to get involved in Quidditch? This World Cup thing sounds like loads of fun. Amazing, you really stepped up to the challenge. I really appreciate your work. Thank you very much. All right, next up is Alice Nightingale, who's here. Alice is one of these people who's really, really quiet. And then you ask her a question, she's like, yeah, I did that 4 months ago. So Alice, have you been keeping track of ticket sales? Yeah, I did that like 7 years ago. So Alice, just thank you for being so on top of everything, making everything run smoothly. Yeah, thank you very much, really appreciate it. Okay, ownership, interesting. Anna Kramlova, Anna, come here. Yeah! So, you may have noticed when looking through the list of names on the organizing committee, there's not many Germans, and there's even less of us who speak German. So Anna, as the token German, has done an amazing job of translating literally everything, and also as the only person on committee with a car, has also been the official taxi. Alongside that, she also organized all of your hotels, has organized the after party tonight, and literally dozens of other things that I probably should have done. So please give her a big round of applause. And if you see her at the after party tonight, please buy her a drink. She said that she's not drinking much, but that's a lie. Okay, next up is Josh Marr. Josh. So Josh has been doing gameplay. And I'm not really into the whole kind of like, let's keep Quidditch close to Harry Potter thing, but Josh is genuinely the first wizard I've ever met. As in, about 3 months ago, I was like, so Josh, how are we doing gameplay? And he linked me to 7 spreadsheets, all of which were about 12 tabs. And he's like, yeah, we're just gonna, well, I had these lying around, so like, if we wanna do these, I guess we could. So thank you so much, Josh, for just being on the ball, just getting things ready in advance and making things run smoother so we can make some noise! Okay, next up, we've got Alex Shear, who's been doing marketing for us. I'll be real. Up until about a week before the event, I was like, you know what? Alex isn't quite pulling his weight. Like, I should have a serious talk with him. And then on the Saturday morning, between about 8 a.m. and 12 p.m, I had about 11 interviews with German media. And I was like, Alex, where did all these people come from? So huge thanks for all your work, all behind the scenes. I hope there's loads of cool news and press that'll come out over the next few days. I've seen some of it already. So huge thank you, Alex, for all your hard work. All right. So the next thing I want to talk about is kind of about a lot of the people who are here and then about a group of people who aren't here. A lot of you will have seen that I've been fronting the Team Uganda campaign. Many of you will have referred to me over this weekend as the Uganda man. I hate to break it to you, I am not Ugandan. There are some telltale signs. I'm sure you can figure those out. I just wanted to do a big thank you. I just wanted to say a big thank you to everybody who donated, supported, shared, made any sort of noise about, told me thank you, gave me support during the Uganda campaign. We really, really appreciate that. It's the first thing of its kind, and I promise we're going to do more stuff like that in the future. Make some noise for all those guys, please. Linked to Uganda, I also want to really thank Savage Ultimate Apparel, who have done all of the jerseys and all of the t-shirts and stuff for the Uganda fundraiser. I know not all of you have got your stuff this weekend, but those of you who have got it, I think you'll agree with me, it's the sexiest thing you've ever put on your body. It's certainly the best thing I've put on mine. I'm very tired. sorry. I also want to thank someone who isn't here, who's been sending me messages of support all weekend, and I would bet you like £100,000 that he's watching on the live stream. You'll know his name from his amazing social media posts. John Sentamu. Yeah! Has messaged me about 20 times over the course of the weekend, wanting exact details on how the tournament is going, and I'm like, John, I love you a lot, but I've got a lot of stuff to be doing. I can't really chat with Uganda right now. I guess after all that, if you could just do one big round of applause for all those people who I've thanked, and then we'll get onto medals and all that kind of stuff. So I want to talk a little bit about the decision process that went behind the medals and the trophy and choosing all of those. It's a pretty well-known thing at most tournaments that getting the medals and the trophies is a bit of a last-minute scramble when you get to the week before the event and you go, ah, we need something to give them. A little bit more thought did go into this. Those of you who receive trophies and medals, and when you see kind of the big one later on, will kind of notice that it's maybe a little bit plainer than you would have thought. Maybe it's not quite as decorative as some medals that you've received in the past. Maybe the trophy isn't as big. We had a bit of a talk about this. We made a conscious decision that no cup, no silver cup would be big enough for what you guys have made this tournament. So we decided to go the other way, and we got possibly the smallest trophy we could find. The reason behind that is that, as many of you who organize tournaments or indeed try to get anything done in your lives will know, that when you're meant to be doing something, it's really, really easy to end up doing other things. So I was meant to be organizing things for this tournament, and I wasn't. And I was looking around on Wikipedia, and I was looking at countries that could potentially attend World Cup in the future. So there's 21 countries here, 26 countries signed up, and as I looked through this list of countries that weren't here, my heart just broke and broke and broke and broke. There's about 153 countries that aren't here. And so what I wanted to do when we chose the trophies and medals was just leave a little bit of space to grow for when we eventually have 174 teams here. So then when we do get to that point, we can have a much bigger cup. I hope that's okay with you guys, and I hope that's okay with Australia when they get up here. I'm sorry if it's not, because I got another one. All right, with that in mind, I guess we'll welcome the bronze medalists. So if Team UK could just make their way over to me here. Quidditch UK in the past and has known most of these guys since they started playing Quidditch. I really appreciate all their hard work. I really appreciate how far they've come and the sweat and tears and blood and that went into this. A huge round of applause for Team UK, please! Second place team, the United States of America. Still be as polite and as respectful as they have been. I just really want you to respect the fact that they've come so far, and despite not getting maybe where they wanted to be, they've still been a great presence at this tournament, and we've really enjoyed having them here. Make some noise! Next up,
medalists at this tournament. A team that have travelled possibly the furthest to be here. Their team that came up with their catchiest nickname for their team rather than Team Australia. The team that has the most green and gold uniforms here. Everyone, please help me in welcoming Team Australia! receive your medals. It's fine, it's going great. Team Australia, if you have medals, you can also wear a bunch of blue cards, that'd be great. To me with commendations for the first ever Team World. After extensive discussion, conversation, argument in several languages, I can now confirm that we have selected 9 members of Team World. As we announced at the opening ceremony, each member of Team World will receive a limited edition Team World jersey. These are not them. These are training shirts so that you can wear them around the house, in your pajamas, and other such occasions, so everyone knows just how great you are. The Team World jerseys will be posted directly to you, and so you can put photos on social media of you rolling around the house in it just to show off how great you are. We're going to get started with the Team World coach. We received about 50 nominations for this position. Given that there's 21 teams here, I think there's 6 other teams that need to have some words. Something needs to happen there. The person who we've selected for this nomination is someone who I've had the pleasure of speaking to over the weekend, and I've been really impressed with their dedication not only to their own team, but all the teams who are here. They've been so dedicated to making sure this event runs smoothly. They've been dedicated to providing support whenever they can for anyone, no matter what team, volunteer, whatever. They've really helped make this event take over and really embody the values of Team World. Ladies and gentlemen, guys, girls and pals, your Team World coach, Ashley Cooper. Yeah! So welcome to do so at the after party. We'll make that happen.
Yeah!
Yes, Ash, wait here, wait here. We're going to do a team photo because that's the things that teams do. Next up, those of you who have volunteered over the weekend will know that if you volunteered a considerable amount, you were entered into the selection for the official Team World volunteer. So many of you have put so many hours towards making this tournament happen, and we really appreciate all of you. There were around 100 volunteers who were shortlisted, having done enough work to be on Team World, and we really appreciate all of you for literally slaving away over the weekend. You've been amazing. This couldn't have happened without you. We would be useless without you, so thank you so much to all of you. This Team World volunteer is someone I had the pleasure of meeting on Thursday, someone I've never met before, and pretty quickly impressed me with their willingness to get stuck in, do things they weren't asked to do, and do things they didn't necessarily actually know how to do, which is always an impressive trait. They've also been responsible for making one of the most impossible things in Quidditch happen, which is a steady, consistent live stream with amazing commentary. ladies and gentlemen, guys, gals, and pals, please welcome me in welcoming Willow Rosenberg. Willow, if you're at the back, let's clear a path, let's do this Moses stuff. I want to do a bit of a warning now that not all of the people who we list as being on Team World may be here. They may have gone home, they might have to catch buses. Please do cheer for them twice as loud as they can hear you over the live stream, capiche? Alright, cheers. So, we're going to start with the seeker for Team World. This is someone who many of you probably won't have noticed, but we received four different acknowledgements for. And after watching them in action, we were determined that they had to be on Team World, representing a country who are here for the first time. Please welcome Verena Deutsch from Slovenia! Verena! Verena! Okay, if she's not here, let's make some more noise for the live stream! Seekers are pretty rare in Quidditch, and Verena consistently impressed us with her dedication towards the team, her unwillingness to quit, and we just love seeing that from a brand new team. What an amazing spirit. Alright. Let's get into the chasers. There are three of them, in case you don't know. The first one made a splash before they even arrived here, with a notorious Facebook post in IQA All The Regions. They have consistently impressed me over the 4 days with their beauty, grace, willingness to provide hugs on demand, and also to provide jerseys from Australia to anyone who wants them. How do you have so many jerseys to swap? This is what I want to know. Damien Osborne! Okay, so next up is a female chaser who has single-handedly brought an entire new nation to the World Cup, literally through sheer sweat, determination, and unwillingness to accept the impossible. Ladies and gentlemen, guys, gals, and pals, Patricia Heiser from South Korea! Yeah. Watch out, guys, I think she is on crutches from some of the injuries. On Team World is simply so talented that recently they released a live-action film about their life. Ladies and gentlemen, guys, gals, and pals from Team France, please help me welcoming Tarzan. Where you at? This beater is someone who has consistently gone in the face of everything everyone thinks about their team. They've really impressed me over the weekend with their humility, their willingness to listen and learn, which are really important traits in such an inclusive community. I'm hoping he's still here. Ladies and gentlemen, guys, gals and pals, Tyler Walker from the United States! I can confirm, is from our host nation, Germany. Make some noise! They've really impressed us over this weekend with one word which we call tenacity. Their willingness to succeed just overpowers every single odd. We've been super impressed with them. Ladies and gentlemen, guys, girls and pals, Leeds and Teamster! Your team world keeper and your team world captain. I first met them a few years ago where they impressed me with their creativity on pitch, their willingness to succeed, and their adverse attitude when off pitch. So when off pitch they're dominating, really fast, really strong. Off pitch like, yeah, I guess we can like get a pizza or something, which I didn't expect. From Belgium. Yes. Members, national governing bodies, please, I present to you, make some noise for your first ever Team World! The stuff we have to get through here whilst you're all here, and then we can do more speeches and pleasantries at the after party. Does that sound like a plan? Yeah! I thought so. So, information about the after party. First of all, 10 p.m. is the time. Sky Club Frankfurt is the place. My one request of you, if you've been playing, please, for the love of God, shower. If you haven't been playing, maybe shower anyway. So that'll be that. What time is that finishing, Anna? Any idea, Anna? That's never finishing. We're doing that until the next World Cup. You guys can keep buying me drinks until 2018. I'm cool with that. The last thing is about clean up and tidy up. There are a shed load of chairs all around here. If, as you leave, you could grab one and take it over to the trolleys that are near the entrance, we would really appreciate that. If there's a black clip, take it off, put it in the box. We'd really appreciate that. Otherwise, ladies and gentlemen, having a good time! Yeah! Do you approve of your first ever Team World? Yeah! Do you approve of the idea of having a few drinks now? Yeah! Good, me too. Alright guys, it's over. Guns out.
Yeah. You're still on line now?
I gave you a little intake. Okay. Because by the time we got over, you already introduced yourself. But then you kept moving around, so I had to keep moving.
I just really wanted to be comfortable.
Yeah, no, that was great. So we got...
Okay. Send someone to here when you're ready.
Ew, they make you.